Hey guys, welcome to Style Class, and I'm Amy, and this is...
Sarah.
What's your name?
Sarah.
And what we're going to talk about today, this week, is shopping with your adjectives in mind. Not outfits, but your adjectives, and your modifier too.
Yeah.
But we'll get to that. And to take a step back, for any of you guys who are new to following us, what we mean by adjectives are the words that we use to describe who we are. Because what we know is that personal style is about exhibiting visually who you are on the inside. And it's very hard to show visually who you are if you can't say it verbally. So what we really challenged ourselves to do about 2 years ago was we started saying, okay, come up with the three words to describe yourself. And we chose three because, well, first of all, three is just the normal rule, right? The rule of three. The rule of three. But also because anything less than three words tends to not give enough of a picture. Right. If I said that I was just chill, then I could look
there's a lot of ways chill is going.
Exactly. So if you're just modern, it could be a little scary, right? So what we did is collectively we came up with our adjectives to describe ourselves. Knowing, first of all, that we kind of live by the premise of being creative pragmatists. And by that, we mean people who are very creative, but also super functional. Mm-hmm. We have a life to live.
Yeah, we have things to do.
We got shit to do. We got work to go to, all of that. So when we came up with our adjectives, we really all started writing down what are the ways that we would describe just the very core essence of our being. And what we came up with was chill, modern, and classic. And it's interesting, when we started asking people to come up with their adjectives, and by people, I mean those of you who follow us, a lot of you came up with synonyms to that. You were like, I'm not effortless, or I'm not chill, I'm effortless.
Which then made us go back to the drawing board almost, and realize that as creative pragmatists, we share in these adjectives.
We do. There's if you did a Venn diagram, that is where we all overlap. So whether or not you were coming up with terms like heritage or curiosity is to be modern. Heritage is to have classical elements. So chill, modern, and classic are the adjectives that we embody. And then what we realized is, you're chill, modern, and classic, and I'm chill, modern, and classic, but it doesn't make us the same.
Totally.
And that's when we dug a little bit deeper and came up with what we call the modifiers, that thing that makes me different than you, than Tracy, than Bryn, than Stella, than all of us, right? We don't run around looking like clones.
I think it's how we really identify our personal style and how my personal style is different from yours, from Bryn's, from Tracy's, etc.
Exactly. So your modifier is risk-taking. And sometimes that really is just about finding the right pieces that on the surface, it's a red cardigan, a red sweater. You're not that is crazy risk taking. But there are ones a cardigan's great because you can really manipulate it.
For sure. And I think that is what really helps me exude that risk taker kind of attitude. Because although, at surface level, this kind of looks like a twin set, which I would consider quite conservative.
Yeah.
But I think because it's super thin and there's a bit of sheerness to it, it makes it a little bit more thought-provoking. And then the thing with the cardigan is that it really creates for optimal styling.
Yeah, you can manipulate it. So, I do love a chunky sweater, but those should really...
But there's kind of a short period of time that you're wearing those. I think,
And they tend to be very, dependent on the skirt or the jean.
Oh, yeah.
It's not dependent. There's just multiple ways to style it.
Right. And I think for me, the idea of this, thin cardigan, it just goes so effortlessly with, all of the other pieces I have in my closet. So I'm never necessarily, making an outfit around this cardigan. I can just always grab it because I know that it will work because I can tie it around me like this or I can tie it through the belt loops.
Yeah, I get a lot of comments from people who are like, what are you supposed to do if you live in a really warm climate? And I always tell people, I grew up on an island off the coast of Georgia. I started the company based in Hong Kong. I am very familiar with heat and humidity. And so one of the things that I always look for is if a sweater is thin enough to actually go through a belt loop. And when that happens, it means like if you're hot, you're not having those layers, like you don't just throw it around your neck because that sometimes gives you extra heat. So being able to tie it down there.
Absolutely, and I think that like that really speaks to the importance of functionality and like as creative practice, how vital that is while still being able to experiment with style.
Yeah, so remember guys, it's not necessarily about applying your modifiers into each piece that you buy. It's knowing that maybe that piece works as your modifier, just depending on its ability to be manipulated and styled. I live in a place that is very traditional, right? I live here, but I'm not like everyone, right? And so I'm always looking for like, what are my subtle cues that I can do that with? You know, is it wearing a big man's watch? Is it wearing this? You know,
even like those tweets. Subtle changes, because they're so not present in the community where you live, that it's so easy for you to be like, oh, I feel like me. And I guess it's ironic to everyone around me because they wouldn't normally gravitate towards.
Yeah, this is like my invisible Linus blanket. Like it gives me that security, but it's not necessarily like screaming out to everyone. Style breakdown. Knowing your adjectives and modifiers really keeps you focused when constructing your personal style. I'm going to feature my friend Temu McPherson here to provide more context around this concept. Temu is the ultimate CP, balancing creativity with pragmatism. Her adjectives are chill, modern, and classic. Just Google her, you'll get that vibe. Temu's modifier, though, is genuine and warm. Every time I'm with her, the first words she speaks are about her son, her family, or my family. I always pay attention to what someone's conversation opener is. It tells you a lot about them. If I met up with Temu and she immediately leapt into something about the latest collab from XYZ, I would think someone had body snatched her. That is so not her vibe. Yet she is absolutely in the thick of fashion. So you can imagine how important it is to her that no matter what show she is attending, that she has those reminders there for herself and for others that she is a very real and genuine person. It also just shows in her smile. You can see other street style pics, lots of blue steel gazes out there, but never on Temu. This knowledge of her adjectives and modifiers really ground her, and it's that grounding she has that keeps her style really clear and personal, allowing her to navigate from all those great neutrals that we call none to the full-on ton fashion looks, but doing it in a way that has a very clear through line. Chill, modern, classic, and absolutely deeply genuine. The outfits. I'm gonna bring on Bryn and Stella here. Stella the person, not the pant.
Yay!
Yay pant, and you too.
We do love the pant though.
We do love the pant.
Stella loves the Stella.
But what's gonna happen is I want you guys to talk about why these really, like, first of all, what tugged at your heartstrings? How do these fall into the whole CMC ratio for you? And what's your modifier? And I wanna see if I'm always curious if someone's modifier matches what I think their modifier is. Although we've already established that Bryn is elegante.
You know, and I actually, today, when I put on this outfit,
did you agree?
I actually agreed for the first
time.
And I get it. And I think I was looking at it in such a way of like, you know, Upper East Side elegance. And then I thought to myself, no, there's so many facets and levels to the word elegant that is me.
Yeah, I think about it's a lady with like a stiff bag, and that's it. I didn't say lady.
Yeah.
Lady to me has all those connotations.
Did you hear about Betty Rothberg?
I felt more like myself. I did put on a different shoe at first, and then Sarah was like, well, try the Baron with this, which is very me. I think I'm very classic when it comes to silhouetting. I have the classic silhouetting of a, you know, a double-breasted jacket and a straight leg trouser pant. But it's very chill. I think it's making me feel sort of constricted or restricted in any way. And for me, I've never felt more like myself.
But really quickly, what I want to say too, and this is a real important cheat for you guys when you are putting together outfits. So you've found something that you've loved. You've found out, like, does it match your CMC? Is it chill, modern, and classic? But one of the things to me that's important when styling this is that this can start to feel very traditional, right? And that it's gray and it's flannel. So those are two very classic vibes. But you've got the broken buttons there that really like speak to the modernity.
Which are meant to be broken.
Totally meant to be broken.
That was
no returns on that, please.
Yeah.
But the other thing too that's really critical here that's giving it good friction, and this is not a coincidence, guys, that this happens, but when there starts to be more interest out there in classic fabrications, that's when you start to see in the accessories, in the shoes, more things like a patent leather or like a strange color or like a mohair or a pony or something like that. So I think the fact that that the Bayrens are brown and they're really glossy and icky, that is what is giving really good friction to this outfit.
And for sure, if this trouser was super fitted, I would not feel anywhere near as chill as I do right here in this.
Earlier today, we have found Miss Stella's Mind Modifier.
Yes!
Yay! Stella found her modifier!
And it's a good one. I feel like it really resonates with me too. It is rebellious, but not in the sense of, you know, I'm a teenager sneaking out to go buy cigarettes. It's rebellious in that I'm from a small town, a very traditional town in Virginia. I went to a private school, uniforms, khaki pants, polo, the whole nine yards, and I have a nose ring. It's not anything crazy, but you know, it's just a little hint of something. I have, you know, a few tattoos, again, not like a total sleeve, but in, you know, kind of funky places. Like I have one right on my hand.
Like if you know Stella and like her background, like it fits. Like you have this like image and you're like, well, wait, keep throwing us this little like,
yeah,
well,
I think I definitely am CMC, but there's also, you know, this desire to paddle against the flow a little bit, but not in a way that's like, whoa, like that's a lot.
Choose, yeah.
So I love a Calder. I do. For me, it's definitely something I've been living in as of late, you know, as it gets a little colder here in New York. I'm still going to the office, but I love dressing it up
a little bit.
Yes.
Thank you, yes. Thank you for coming to the office.
I'm here.
Yeah.
So, you know, just to kind of, you know, bring in that rebellion, I am wearing a classic shirt, but it's more of a masculine plaid. There's like some interesting, there's extra button loops, so it's just a little something extra. And I actually did the little.
By button loops, she meant buttonholes.
Oh, yep. Thank
that's
you.
Cool. That's
buttonholes.
Cool. She's not designed.
She's rebellious.
Yes.
She's rebellious.
Yes.
She's rebellious. It's new.
Loops to me.
You're hitting your first.
It's enough.
I did. All right. Okay. Bye, guys. I did the rubber band trick just because I do like a slimmer shirt, but I am a little hippier. So, you know, when it splits open a little bit naturally, I like to emphasize that. And I think it adds an interesting proportion, too. And then, you know, a little sheer sock, shiny shoe moment, and I feel like one piece.
And that, again, that patent leather shoe, when you think about your clothing and your accessories as beyond just making outfits, but as tools, patent leather gives all of that friction as well. And that's where a nice, like, Napa leather shoe might not just be interesting enough to lift those colors.
So you see that we're all wearing a different variation of a patent.
Yeah, it really, I mean, again, it is a tool that completely, I'm wearing it too with this jean because this has a more faded out jean, and so like that rich texture of the patent against it gives it the good friction.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's good.
In the jacket too.
The
this
western.
Is the recycled cashmere. This is our Liam, which we all know I love. If I'm not wearing
she's not wearing a Stella, she's wearing a Liam.
If it's not in the black, it's in the dark stone. But this one has that really cool western detailing, which again is just like a little hint of toughness that I always crave in my outfits.
Yeah, that really does lean into the whole modifier because it has that western detailing, but it's not smacking you in the face. You've got broken buttons too.
You do, and they are on purpose.
Does it have a zip out thing?
This one does. The vest isn't in it right now just because we're indoors.
Yeah.
But she does exist.
But that's right. So that's a good time to take that vest out for sure. So.
I know for a lot of you guys, this is a real mindset shift. You've been told to create all these outfits in your closet, but when you really start thinking of these items as tools, for continually building, it's going to be a game changer. So just stay with us here on this. My reason for showing these outfits here today is so that you can see tools at work.
We're back with another variation. Do you want to go first?
Yeah, I can go first. So, I mean, as you can see, a slim shirt and sort of a baggier pant is a uniform for me these days. This is the Acid Wash Sam, which is the love of my life. And again, it's, you know, kind of a classic denim shape. I have it in the classic wash, but the acid wash is, again, like just that little push at, you know, just a little bit more. And then this is sort of...
So I have a question.
Yes.
Super quick. So if you are talking about, you fell in love with it, you went through the chill modern classic checklist, right? So what need in your closet then did this acid wash really fill for your closet? Because I'm assuming you have lots of other denim, right?
I do. I actually, that's the most piece of clothing that I own, the biggest category in my closet.
Yeah.
But for me, I think what filled the gap with this jean is that, you know, when I want to wear denim, but I don't want to wear, you know, the same... the same jeans I have stacked under my bed. This is like, this is really like the denim that I'm craving. The acid wash, you know, it's like, it's pretty heavy duty compared to the rest of my jeans. So I think that's where this comes in.
I think what's interesting too is, I think if you think about Tibi and it's so grounded in chill, modern, and classic, if you don't really understand your style, I think that's where people come to me and they're like, I don't get it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why is there acid wash here? And I'm like, because when a lot of the pieces that you lean into have that kind of effortlessness and that classic vibe, that acid wash gives it the really good friction, which makes sense with your modifier, especially is, you know, just if you think that you're like all clean and black and white and everything, like that gives it like the really good friction.
Mm-hmm. There's a little hint of something.
That's your rebellion antenna.
Yeah.
There you go.
And then I feel like the rebellion aspect kind of pours over into the jacket as well, because, you know, it is, it's your standard bomber, but it's not. You know, it has the shiny chrome buttons that are super clean. Well, there's a drawstring down here, which gives you that nice like bunch. Which again is like that friction that I really love, and it's functional too, you know?
Well, and I think what's important too is like, if you turn to the side, one of the things about this bunch is that, what the technical term bunch in fashion, but what it's doing is it's giving a shape.
Mm-hmm.
When we talk about interesting proportions, again, it's not about making you look thinner, taller, whatever. It is about creating interesting sculpture and shape on the body. So that is exactly what this is doing. It is designed to give interest and shape and modernity.
Mm-hmm.
And when we talk about big, slim skin, that of course plays a big role. You guys might travel to southern areas where you go to sporting events. And to me, this is the ultimate to wear to a sporting event, because it absolutely says, like, I still have style. I have personal style. You don't look crazy
mm-hmm.
in the stands or whatever. Like, oh my God, really? Did you fucking wear that to a game? Crazy. Like, you're fully appropriate, but you have style.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that is that whole rebellious thing for sure.
Mm-hmm. And I've definitely gotten my fix with the rebellion. You know, I have the bomber, I have my acid wash, but then I swapped out the shiny shoe for just a Napa leather Rudolph, which I feel like keeps me grounded in the whole CMC.
And then I think what's great too about this jersey shirt is I just wore it the other day when I was going to work out, and I just layered it as a cardigan under my Liam. So, you know, when Sarah was saying she loved her red cardigan because of all the different ways that you can manipulate it, that's what's great about this shirt too.
Layering our True True sweater on top of our fan favorite pleated skirt, and I'm wearing our compact stretch knit, which you're wearing the sister version of.
Yeah, so she's got on the cream.
Yep.
Yeah.
And to me, this just makes me feel like myself. I've never been a skirt person until the past like 6 months. I don't know what it is. I think it was because there was so much talk about skirts needing to be mini in fashion things, and I think that's why people stray from it. But a midi or a maxi skirt really holds such a different vibration, and I think it also mimics more of a baggier pant or a straight leg pant, which you can really, to me, feels a lot more chill. Like this skirt, like while it might flow, and it does have that elegant piece, which to me fits into my modifier, it's like flowy and baggy enough, not like flowy in a way where I still feel chill. And you know, the holes in the sweater are giving me modern.
One of the things that we wanted to come up with when we were designing that skirt was, we were like, what is a skirt that would play as effortless a role in your closet as a style of pant wear?
Yeah.
And that's really what that skirt does. So when you think about buying to your adjectives, you are also then thinking about what is the role these things are going to play long-term in your closet.
I think because to me it mimics such a, like, you know, vibe of a style of pant with the effortless flow, I can think to myself, what would I wear with my style of pant? And sort of like reverse it and put it back to this skirt because it's the same notion.
So in this vein of thinking of your clothes as tools, I'm going to focus on the Reynolds plaid shirt that Stella was wearing. Here I've used it as a tool to take this skirt down a notch, making it more casual. An outfit that is not an outfit. And the cashmere dress is super luxe. What this means is, oh, I want to wear it a lot. I paid a lot for it. So mixing it with this shirt makes it much more appropriate for just going to town for lunch with friends. The plaid shirt is my tool for just showing my personality. In my town, you can do your skinny jeans with the fancy blouse, and I'll do me with this red sock included. The fine wool Rodney trouser, this gets to the heart of not having a bifurcated closet, because while we love it head to toe, when you mix it up here with the plaid and the red cardigan, it just simply looks like the clothes that I will wear a lot. Same thing applies here to getting use out of the strapless mini dress. So the plaid shirt, it's that tool in my closet that I use to take things down a notch, or when I am just living my life and I want to be more without being extra. And if you know, you know. You know, this is one where this coat is obviously a very emotional draw for me. Yeah. This is Stella had on the shorter one earlier, and this is the long version of it. But you can see that this has the inset vest that can be zipped out. And then it's got the Western detailing and the broken buttons. So for me, this is an emotional love verse.
Right.
It ticks off all the chill, modern, and classic hits. And then, you know, at my age, like, I've had the slow buildup of my wardrobe. So the other thing that I'm gonna look at as well is making sure, like, do I have anything in my closet that is already serving this function? And this is where, guys, I think that I really do want to help you make sure that you do not get a closet that is bursting at the seams.
Right.
And I think that buying smartly is a great thing, no matter what your wallet looks like. And so for me, if I already had a long, dark coat that could really function in that way that I could wear it on the weekend with jeans, but I could also wear it over something quite dressy now. If I already have that, then I don't need it. And a lot of you in the closets when I'm dressing, customers will come in and they're like, well, I already have something that's doing exactly this, but I really love this one. And this is where I'm like, take a pass on.
Yeah.
Take a pass. You don't need both. I promise there is enough good stuff that you'll find other things
Absolutely.
That are going to fill a need in your closet. For me, though, this is filling a need. It has been a while since I've had this kind of luxurious overcoat, especially with where I live, having that functionality of that vest that can go zip in and out is really key. And then I love to, like, I'm just wearing it over. This is from the resort collection. And this is the hooded, I look so dork ass with a hood. So let me tell you, what I like about a hood is I love it coming out of a jacket. I love the way it looks right here, and I'm not gonna put it on my head because.
You just got your hair done.
No, fuck you, all right, here you go.
Oh my God, were you in the resort campaign?
Yeah, I was. Such a bitch. Okay, anyway, so, but that coat over this, like, it just works.
Sure.
And then again, I keep leaning into the pattern, and you've got on the pattern.
Yeah.
So, the pattern's good.
Because it's giving that good friction, because it's such a familiar shape. Like,
yeah.
This is the Bronson shape. This is honestly the shape of, like, the Daniel and Ola first go around. Now,
yeah.
This is a Cameron and Q, so it's a little bit different. But it's something that, like,
we've always worn, so we're super comfortable in the silhouette, and yeah. So the pattern really doesn't change that much. It just gives it like a little bit more, a little bit something.
Yeah, and so I'm explaining that because, okay, like I said, if you've got something in your closet that's already, you know, if you're looking at that heel and you're like, I already have a high heel in my closet for evening, okay, yes, you might.
Totally.
But what you might not have is that heel that might even seem like it's in such a specific color, but because it's in such a specific color and because it's glossy, it is ironically the heel that, like,
you're gonna gravitate towards most.
It makes the whole outfit.
It totally
like
does.
It's making this whole outfit. If you were just in like a black, like, highly subtle, like, it would be nice.
It would be nice. It just also, like, wouldn't be me, and it would really do nothing for my modifier.
Yeah, it really leans into risk-taking.
Right. So I think for me, like, this dress, it's a great small black dress, and I think, you know, I think the little black dress is something that's, like, so iconic, whatever. Every woman should have one in her closet. For me, what I feel is super unique here is the neckline, and just how it adds a point of interest here. It's not loud. The length is like a very comfortable length. But to make it work more with my personal style, I added a colorful tight, a contrary shoe. That to me says risk taker.
Mm-hmm.
Versus, sure, I could have done a sheer black tight. I could have just done like a black open toe sandal.
And which you will.
Which I will for other things.
Yeah.
But for right now, to really like get the point across of like how I utilize my modifier when I'm getting dressed, I felt so comfortable working with this.
The modifier thing really is such a overarching like touch that happens somewhere within the wardrobe, and not on every single piece.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like everything has to be risky.
Absolutely not.
I talk about humorous and that little thing that just says I'm a little bit different than those around me. For me, that's where this hood does come into play.
Right.
You know, if this dress did not have that hood on it, like, I would love it, but the hood is what gives it that
little push,
extra
that,
something.
And that also, it's the thing that, like, I think you emotionally like connect with. I think that's why as a whole this dress like really speaks to your adjectives, because it's
I also think, too, it's funny, we don't talk about this often, but it's really funny. All of us here at Tibi do tend to play a sport. Played a sport. And so those sporty elements, too, I think when we talk about what chill means to us, I think for a lot of us, finding chill in sport elements
for sure
is very natural to do that. So if I have something with a hood on, it doesn't feel at all pretentious, or it doesn't feel like I'm trying to do like a street vibe or anything like that. It just feels very comfortable and familiar. In conclusion, so I want to leave you with everything that we've shown you is that the closet should be a slow burn.
Yeah.
I don't care where you are in your process, whether you are 18, 35, 65, and onward. Let it be a slow build. This is not something to go out tomorrow. You don't like have your shopping list of adjectives and run around the supermarket.
And we don't want you to also like throw everything out. We're not telling you to get rid of everything that you own. You need to start with the pieces that you have that work into everything that we just went over.
Exactly. So here's a couple thoughts to leave on. Number one, just because you look great in something does not mean that you feel good in it. If you look great in it and you feel good, fine, that's great, perfect. But it is not the be-all and all by any stretch. And also, one person's great is not another person's great. I mean, there are a lot of things that my grandmother thought that I had great in where I'm like, Bernice, I don't know. Another thing that I want to leave you with is that if you cannot communicate verbally what your style is, then it is next to impossible to showing it visually in a continuous way. But once you can articulate who you are verbally, you will start to use that as your benchmarks for what it is that you're buying. And if you do start to put things always through that filter of chill, modern, and classic, and then for you, is there something risky that I can do with some of the things?
Right.
Is there something humorous about it for me that will just kind of make you like tilt your head? Those are the filters that you really should be putting your buys through. Because when you do that, what you're going to see is your closet is just going to start to slowly build and build and build. And that's where then you can filter in all the other things that we talk about, which is big, slim skin, how to work those color, no colors.
Totally.
One ton or none.
And I think a good tip when you're shopping is to shop at places that carry other brands that fit into that CMC mentality.
Yes.
So I think, you know, we love Schneeweiss. We love
Kickflea, Wendy and Kickflea, Lance and Jim at Space 519.
Max.
We love Max.
So they, you know, the boutiques that we work with, it's a partnership. So mm-hmm. we want to make sure that Tibi is represented with other brands that may also share a bit with our mindset. We want you to be able to feel like you're going to build a wearable closet.
You know, you want to go with a store that has a similar mindset or someone that can help guide you with other items too that fit
for
into
sure.
that vibe of chill, modern, and classic, so that you can really understand the difference between like something that is a longer rise versus something that's like a drop crotch and, you know, makes you walk like that. So it's all part of an education, and it is really helpful, you know, shopping with people like Sherry McMullen or Stacy at Hampton. And of course, like you mentioned, Yasmin at Schneeweiss. So guys, I hope this was helpful. Remember, shop smart, shop with your adjectives, and it doesn't have to be all Tibi. And in fact, it should not be all Tibi, and we are absolutely cool with that.
Yeah.
All right?
We want to be realistic.
Yeah. We're keeping it real. And enjoy, and as always, DM us with any of your questions. Hope to hear from you guys. Bye.